Thank you. Edwin.
Edwin.
And after Mass is done, you will process with the cross from there until here the God. And all of you will follow her, okay? And we come here right after Mass. We take one picture with everybody, and next is the time to do the to take the pictures. Okay?
They've already taken
them off. Oh, yes?
Yes, we're good.
Finalmente tenemos estos 14 niños preparados para la primera comunión. Queremos dar gracias por estas familias, por estos niños que pasaron tanto tiempo preparándose y tanto esfuerzo para estar aquí recibiendo la primera comunión. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
For the apostles, when Peter entered, Cornelius met him, and falling at his feet, paid him homage. Peter, however, raised him up, saying, "Get up, I myself am also a human being." Then Peter proceeded to speak and said, "In truth, I see that God shows no partiality. Rather, in every nation, whoever fears him and acts uprightly is acceptable to him." While Peter was still speaking these things, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who were listening to the word. The circumcised believers who had accompanied Peter were astounded that the gift of the Holy Spirit should have been poured out on the Gentiles also. For they could hear them speaking in tongues and glorifying God. Then Peter responded, Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people who have received the Holy Spirit, even as we have? He ordered them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends, because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. This I command you, love one another. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I want to ask you all a question. What was the most important thing that Jesus taught? Okay, use your outside voices. What did you... Louder. Okay, thank you very much. Love is so important that about 100 years ago, a great author wrote a story about love. And I want to tell you that story. It was written just for First Communion children. Please go ahead and sit down. And so as the story goes, once upon a time, in a land far, far away, and long, long time ago, there was a beautiful little city. And in that city, there was a great castle, huge, huge castle, larger than any church. And in that castle lived a man that was, maybe 5 or 6 or 7 times taller than me, which is pretty easy to be. Some people called him a giant. And in around that castle, there were gardens. And in that garden, it was a huge garden, beautiful garden. There were apple trees and pear trees and cherry blossoms and just thousands and thousands and thousands of beautiful flowers. And the children in the town used to stop and play in the garden whenever the giant wasn't home, because he didn't like them playing in the garden. So they played in the garden year after year after year. One day, the giant came home early, and he found all the children in the garden playing, and he got angry, and he threw them all out of the garden. Just said, get out of my garden. I don't like you here. I don't want you here. And he built a great wall around the garden, and on the outside of the wall, there was a big sign that said, no children allowed in the garden. And you know why he did that? Because he had no love in his heart. And immediately upon building that wall and putting up the sign, winter came. And winter stayed in the garden for year after year after year. While everybody outside was enjoying the summer and the spring and the flowers in the garden, it was always winter for many years. Hail, snow, rain, was cold, dark, foggy. So after many years, one day the giant woke up and he looked out his window and he heard the children playing in the garden. He looked out and the flowers were blooming. And he knew right then and there that he was doing the wrong thing, that he had no love in his heart, and he wanted love in his heart. So he went outside and he told the children that they could play in the garden forever as long as they wanted to, and he took down the wall, he took down the sign, and every year thereafter, the children were allowed to play in the garden. Now, what did Jesus teach mostly? And what did the giant now have in his heart? Love. That's right. That's right. And that story was written just for you, so that you know how important it is that we all have love in our hearts. Now, for the rest of us, that story is called The Selfish Giant. It was written, maybe a little over 100 years ago by Oscar Wilde, the infamous or famous poet, Irish poet, you may have heard of him. And it was written right after Wilde was baptized a Catholic as his commentary for everybody on Christ's commandment of love. And basically what he was saying, and I'm sure you figured it out, is when we love, when we do not love, when we do not put love out there, we build kind of like a wall around ourselves. But we ourselves are the first to suffer. We condemn ourselves to a winter of discontent. A winter, when we don't love, we condemn ourselves to a winter of loneliness and unhappiness. But when we love, the wall falls down, or apparently falls down, and we open ourselves up to others, and we ourselves are the first then to benefit from that. We experience a springtime of friendship, goodwill, peace, and joy. Joy is the most important. And let me read to you again the words of the gospel, Jesus' words. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. And this is the important sentence. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and your joy might be complete. See, joy is different from happiness. Happiness is fleeting. Today, you're happy with your husband or your wife. Tomorrow, you're not happy with your husband or wife. Today, you're happy with your car. Tomorrow, you're not happy with your car. Today, you're happy with this. Tomorrow, you're unhappy with that or something else. But joy stays forever. Once you have joy in Christ, that stays forever. And that is what he was saying to you. That my joy may be in you and your joy might be complete. Jesus always talks about joy and love in the same breath. This is because they are intimately connected. The more love you have in your heart, the more love you exude to the people around you, the more joyful you are. Joy is a result of a heart filled with overwhelming love. The amount of joy that we have is in direct proportion to the amount of love in our hearts. My friends, if we are not as joyful, not happy, happy comes and goes, if we are not as joyful as we might like to be, maybe that's telling us something.
Y ahora unas palabras para las personas que no comprenden inglés. No voy a repetir la historia que el diácono dijo sobre este gigante que no tenía amor en su corazón. Pero quiero decir a los padres, especialmente de los niños, ustedes tienen este amor en sus corazones y sus hijos, tienen este amor en sus corazones. ¿Por qué? Porque Dios es amor. En la segunda lectura hemos leído que Dios es amor y Dios entró a nuestros corazones para que nosotros podamos compartir este amor con los demás. Y ustedes comparten este amor hoy día con sus hijos y sus hijas. Lo que hacemos hoy día llamamos la primera comunión. ¿Por qué la primera comunión? Porque por primera vez los niños reciben a Jesús Eucarístico a sus corazones. Yo durante años y años de ser sacerdote celebré muchas primeras comuniones. Pero siempre quiero subrayar algo que es importante. En muchos casos, la primera comunión se convierte en la última comunión. ¿Por qué la última comunión? No porque el niño se muere. No, porque los padres no ponen suficiente esfuerzo para traer a su niño para que él, ella, reciba la comunión por segunda, tercera, cuarta, quinta vez. Pues por eso yo les quiero pedir a los padres especialmente para que no hagan eso, para que no conviertan la primera comunión en la última comunión de sus hijos. Quiero decirles que todos los esfuerzos de ustedes que hicieron hasta este momento están pagando en este momento. Ustedes hicieron gran esfuerzo, gran sacrificio, y ahora con los felices ojos pueden ver sus hijos e hijas recibiendo a Jesús. Please stand up.
Thank you.
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that purified by your righteousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is to be right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, Lord, but in this time above all, to love you and more gloriously when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of old to fulfillment in the reality of the cross, and by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they play. Broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that we have felt us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Philip, our Bishop and Lord the Clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, you may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. To the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
can't see her.
Which one?
The one behind Leonardo.
Emily.
Jacob, put with Emily.